It's alive! It's alive! This is the Standard SR100 very unusual cassette recorder. And I say it's alive! It's alive! Because it was DOA when I got it from eBay. It came in this case, this leather case. It is a real leather case. That's a mess, and I have to find a way to restore the case. But this is the little unit. The music that we played at the beginning is from our Sinfonia Felina cassette album, which you can get at clydesight, and the title piece is called Frankenstein. So that's appropriate to this. This is one of the most unusual little cassette recorders I've ever seen, made by the Standard Radio Corporation of Japan. It's model number SR100. The functions are on the side. It has a play function, a fast forward, and a rewind function, a simple volume control. The record switch is on the front. There is a battery meter and a VU meter. There is provision for 9-volt DC input, earphone output, and a remote microphone input. The unit is pretty scarred on the back, which is another tie-in to Frankenstein with all the scars there. And it runs on AA batteries, which sit here to make a 9-volt system. It is one of the tiniest original tape recorders for cassettes that I've ever seen. The cassette just pops in here. The back of the case is held by two screws, which when you remove it, you can remove the entire back of the case. Very similar to the SR200 reel-to-reel tape recorder. And looking at the inside of the machine, we also see another similarity where you have a motor driving a very large capstan flywheel through a white rubber belt. Like the SR200 reel-to-reel tape recorder, the entire deck comes out of the case. When I open this and flip it over, be prepared for some surprising. The inside of the machine is designed more like a reel-to-reel tape recorder than a cassette recorder. It doesn't use the standard design of the Norelco, the Wallensack, or the Lloyd's 8V84A. This is an entirely unique design, much more closely related to the SR200 reel-to-reel tape recorder than a cassette recorder. The capstan has a double bearing system. Underneath the plate that holds the lockdown tabs for the cassette, the capstan has a pulley. This pulley drives a small white rubber belt that wraps around the take-up reel table and then around this idler here and then back to the pulley on the capstan. This is how it transfers power for rewind or for fast forward. This take-up reel table is very unique in its design. Underneath this brass piece is a racetrack containing a number of very, very, very tiny ball bearings. Those ball bearings are part of the system so that it can put pressure on this table for the clutch mechanism when it's put into play mode, and then increase the pressure for fast forward or release the pressure for rewind. And this is why I like to look at the inside of these tape recorders, because the imagination cleverness that the companies come up with is very inspiring and fascinating to look at. Another unique characteristic of this machine is that the heads are at an angle, and when the mechanism is put into play, the heads swing up. Now look at this erase head as we swing it up into play mode. You see how that swings? That's very different from the standard Norelco design. The record button is another interesting characteristic. Most machines are required to have a record interlock located back here, so that if you pop the tab out of the back of the cassette, you will not be able to make a recording. In this machine, when the tab is in the forward position and you push the record button, it simply has an open switch here preventing the machine from actually moving. So you can see there's no motion whatsoever. There's the rewind. And there's the fast forward. Now, I did not get a microphone with this unit, so I'm using my Radio Shack replacement, which has a different remote plug, so I will not be able to use this remotely. And I just simply plug it into the top of the machine here. And my little meter here is going to tell me how well I'm making my recording. So to make this work, you press the record button over and push the lever up. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test of the Standard SR100 cassette recorder. Very unusual design, very unusual unit. End of test. Did you see that pop back? So now we rewind. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test of the Standard SR100 cassette recorder. Very unusual design, very unusual unit. End of test. That is a tour of the Standard SR100 cassette recorder. It's an AC bias machine. It's cute as a button. I think it's absolutely adorable. It works very well now that it's alive.